Hi friends, in my previous video we have discussed briefly about refraction of light. So I have informed that in my next video I will upload the more videos which are related to refraction of light. So just I will revise few steps about refraction. Refraction is a property of the light where the speed and the direction of the light changes when it transfers from one medium to another medium. It is a refraction. Next, medium. The medium, it is the substance, like it is the transparent substance where the light travels, is known as medium. Next, example of medium are air, glass, water, kerosene, alcohol we have taken. Next, see, I have taken two mediums, that is rarer medium, denser medium. Rarer medium means here the particles are far away from each other. In this case, either particles are far away, the speed of the light will be faster. Next, coming to denser medium, the particles are closely packed. So as the particles are closely packed, the speed of the light decreases. Coming to my diagram, I have taken air medium and water medium. In this, air is lighter than water. So air will become as the rarer medium and water will become as the denser medium. Next, coming to our topic, today's topic, refraction of light at plane surfaces. In that first, vacuum. What is vacuum? A medium which does not contain particles is called as vacuum. So from this sentence we can understand that vacuum is a place or it is a medium where there is no particles and the speed of light will be more. So why? Because there is no particles, so there is no obstacle for the passing of light, so the speed of the light will be more. See, the speed of the light is highest in vacuum. Its value is c. The c is the letter which is denoted for the speed of the light in vacuum, that is 3×10^8 meters per second, approximately 3 lakhs kilometers per second. Next, normal line. This is the case I asked in my previous video. See, now we will check what is normal line. The line which is perpendicular to surface of denser medium is called normal. So I will take and see example. It is the air, the rarer medium, and water, the denser medium. See, the rarer medium and water, it is denser medium. So the line which is perpendicular to the denser medium, it is known as normal line. The dotted one, it is taken as normal line. It will be perpendicular to the denser. Next, when a ray of light goes from a rarer medium to denser medium, it bends towards the normal line. So according to this point, whenever the light, it starts, the light which is, it is called as the incident ray, the ray which is passing from the rarer medium to denser medium, in this case the emergent ray, the refracted ray, will be close to the normal line. This case happens when the light travels from rarer medium to denser medium. Opposite of this case, that is when a light ray goes from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. So in this case, totally opposite, that is the light is traveling from denser medium, that is water to air. In this case, see, the incident ray, it is traveling towards the rarer medium, and after hitting the interface, it travels far away from the normal. This is the path. See, the angle is more in the passing of light from denser medium to rarer medium. This is the case. This is the two properties. The first case is the case where when the light is traveling from rarer to denser, in this case the refracted ray will be close to the normal. Coming to the next step, in this step the light will travel from denser to rarer, totally opposite of previous. When the light is traveling from denser to rarer, the refracted ray will be far away from the normal line. This is the case, it is important, don't get confused here. Next, refractive index. The ratio of speed of light in vacuum to speed of light in that medium is called as a refractive index. So the speed of light in vacuum and whatever the medium you have taken for that ratio, that is refractive index, denoted with the letter n, n equal to speed of light in vacuum to speed of light in any other medium. Refractive index n equal to c by v. Next, it gives the idea of how fast the light travels in a medium. If you do the speed of light in vacuum or speed of light in any other medium, then you will get the refractive index. So the refractive index says how fast the light travels in a medium. So whatever the medium you have taken, to find the speed of light in that medium, the refractive index helps you a lot. Next, it changes from material to material. So I already said, from material to material, the density will be vary. So as the density is varying, the speed of light will be vary. Like in air, the speed of light will be more. And water, the speed of light will be less compared to air. So like this, from material to material, it changes. Next, Snell's law. It is the important law. See, I've taken brief. The ratio of sine of angle of incidence to sine of angle of refraction is constant for a given pair of media. So Snell's law says that sine I by sine R, that is ratio of sine of angle incidence to ratio of sine of R, angle of refraction, equal to constant. Here constant is refractive index N. So whatever the constant is there, it is taken as N. That is N equal to sine I by sine R. Finally, we can write N1 means medium 1, medium 1 to sine I. Sine I equal to medium 2 sine R. It is a Snell's law. Snell's law is that N1 sine I equal to N2 sine R.